Ladies and gentlemen, good evening. Tonight we're going to talk about why we should not use doubles for solving math problems in Java, and why we in general should be very, very careful when we are choosing our types and when we want to use some simple math, actually. Let us get right into it so I can show you the problem. So I'll create a my double demo right here. This is a class, and then I'll create a main right here. And then I'll create one double, double one equals 0.9 or 0.8. Then we have another double, d2 equals 0.1. And then we say double d3 equals d1 minus d2. And then we system out the results. And of course, we would expect to have 0.7 as the result. But let us just see what actually happens right here. We have 0.7, and then we have a 1 in the end. So we already have a small error right here. Let us try to change these numbers here. We can try to have 3 and then to have 1. Let us see what happens here again. This time we have 0.199999 and then 8 in the end. So this is not exactly what we would expect, right? Because we are using some quite exact numbers right here, right? With just one precision right here. So it's a little bit annoying that a double actually gives us a wrong number. And this is not very good if you are calculating like your tax return or something like that with Java. Then of course there cannot be any money missing. Of course, they will not be passed if you have an accountant, of course, to check up on it afterwards. So let us try with a float instead, just for fun. So just try with a float. Float and float. Let us just check what actually happened here then. Float. 0.20, so that's still an error. So what should we do if we want to do some more exact calculation? Just for fun, we can actually try to multiply our doubles with something instead. We can try to have we are setting our doubles here again. And then instead of d3, instead of this is d1 minus d2, then we can have d2, and then we can multiply it with itself and then see what actually happens. So maybe the problem only occurs when we are subtracting numbers. So let us just try d2, multiply by d2 again. And you can see again here, we get a small error in the end right here. We get 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, and then 2, which is too much. This is not the exact result, right? So we have another option, and that is a big decimal. But with the big decimal, we also need to be careful. Big decimal, it is a little bit slower to use than the double and the floats, but it is also it's more exact also. The correct way of creating a new big decimal is not by using the constructor and then passing on double, because that would actually also give an error. So let me just show that. So if I say big decimal, new big decimal right here, and then we say d1, and then we have, I'll just say this is big decimal 1 right here, then we have big decimal 2 right here, and then we have big decimal 3 right here. So this is d2, and then we have big decimal 3 is then equals BD1 subtract BD2, and then we want to system out the big decimal result right here plus BD3 like this, and we run again. Let us just see what we get now. Now we also get something. We now get something even weirder, but it's more precise. There's a higher precision. We can see we get more decimals on this number compared to the double number that we got before. So we can kind of feel that we have a higher precision when we are using big decimals. But the problem was actually here that I used this constructor right here to create my big decimal. If I want to create my big decimal from a double, then I should use the value of and then the double, because what actually happens behind the scenes is actually the string constructor is used instead, and that actually works. It's much more exact. So let us just say here BD1 minus BD2, and let us just check what the result is now. So now I'm creating the big decimal the right way with value of We can see here right now we get 0.2 instead. So be careful when you're using big decimal, but I would never use doubles or floats for any kind of math or calculation. At least if you do that, then you need to know that the precision is not that high, and that it actually can give you problems, right? It can give you especially if you start rounding or maybe using the floor. If you're using the math floor on some of your numbers, then you will get then the result will be even worse, of course. If we go down to the value of them, we can see we have a new big decimal, and then we are actually it's actually the double dot to string, which is executed right here, and then on the value right there. So that means it's actually converted into a string. So that means that if I use the to string constructor instead, then I will actually also get the right result. So that means if I write new big decimal, and then if I write 0.3 like this, new big decimal 0.1 like this, and then we subtract the numbers, then we should still get the right number right here. Now we got 0.2. So I've been on many projects where the math was actually just slightly off, and the result was actually slightly off. The math was fine, of course, but the result was slightly off because the developers used doubles instead of the big decimals. Then the problem is a little bit less visible if it's not a decimal. So let's say that I have the number 3 right here instead, and then I have the number 1 down here, and then we say D3 minus D1. Then it actually works. D1 minus D2. That's what I wanted to do. And then let's just look at the first number. Let's see what did we get here. You see now we get 2.0. So this the problem occurs when we are dealing with decimals usually. That's just what I want to say tonight. Be careful, don't use doubles and floats when you are if you want to have an exact result. And when you're using the big decimal, be careful, do not use the constructor, just use the value of. I think you're pretty safe there. Let me just check if there are any of them. Dot value of, then we can actually add the double along, and yeah, then you should actually be fine. If you use the value of when you're creating your big decimal, then it's fine. Or if you if you're passing on a string, then of course you just need to check that the string process is as you wanted it to be, of course. That's all for me for tonight. Thank you very much for watching. I hope you have a great evening, and hope to see you again soon. And do not use doubles for if you want to be exact result. Thank you very much. Bye-bye.